Hello everyone, I'm Heather and I'm coming to you live from my office. Well, it's not live, but I am in my office. And it's the first time I've been in my office for about 15 months, I guess, since last March, or like March 2020, when the university was shut down. And I haven't been here since then. I've been working from home. Everyone in the office has been working from home. Like, the students have pretty much been working from home as well. Like, they come in, I think, every once in a while for like seminars and stuff, but only when there's not a lockdown on, which there was up until roughly last month. So they've done this thing where they want everyone to come in like on a rotation, you know, like twice a month or once a month or whatever, just sort of come into the office and like man the building. So I'm literally the building, this whole school. I am the staff member. And I was a bit worried what I was gonna find when I got here, right? So I was like, what if I come in and I don't have a computer anymore? Like, somebody in a panic over the last 15 months was like, I need this now, and just took it. Or like my chair, or like, you know, just like cables missing, random people needed cables, so they've taken that. Like, I didn't know what I was gonna find. So all of the work that I needed to do today, I did yesterday. On Sunday, I was like, I have anxiety about what I'm gonna find when I get to the office. So that was a really good idea, because when I got here, I didn't have a chair, and also I couldn't boot my computer. But that took about 20 minutes to sort out, and now it's all sorted. I have internet, and I have a chair, and I have a computer, and everything works. And I still have ages left in this workday. There's no one to talk to. There's nothing to do. So I'm massively bored now, and I think I might just have like a look around and sort of like a go through everything. Everything is like frozen in March of 2020, so I haven't looked in the fridge yet. But there can't be anything good in there, in it. Oh, all lists. Oh shit. My planner! Oh yeah. Stuck on March 2020. March 16th. Gross. Gross. Is this soap? Gross. Okay, I'm like working my way through Magic for Liars by Sarah Gailey. It's been taking me a long time to get through it because I keep getting distracted by other books. But I don't know why, because it's really good, it's going really well. Like, at the minute, this girl, she's investigating, so she's like not magical, she's like the muggle sister. She's investigating this magical crime that happened at this magic school that her sister works at, who is magical, the sister. And she's like a PI, but PIs never get to do the fun work anymore because the cops have to do it all. Boring. So she's excited about this because she's like, oh, it's the only sort of case where a PI would be able to do like a murder investigation. So she's like going about it, and she's finding some super creepy stuff. Like, at the minute, there's this kid who's on about how he's like supposed to be super smart and like fulfill this sort of prophecy type thing. But he's also like, I guess, one of the witnesses or whatever to the murder, where this woman who teaches there, or like is a librarian or whatever, was literally cut in half, and like the two pieces of her body were like in different parts of the room or whatever, or like the description of it was that they were turned away from each other, like the two halves of the body don't like each other much. But as the PI is like looking at all the photos and everything of this like messed up body, she's also drinking loads of gin, which is exactly how I would do it. So I have a deep connection with this. Also, there's some sort of like magical graffiti on the lockers that no one can get rid of, even the teachers and everything, and like if you touch it, it zaps you, and it says Samantha's a slut. And I feel like if my high school was a magical high school, that would be deeply relatable. Oh my god, working from the office sucks now. Used to be so amazing, coming in to see everyone, having a chat, getting work actually done quickly because there's no one around to super bug you. No husband coming upstairs to like talk about why the laundry's not done, you know, stuff like that. But now it's just shit. There's no one around. I'm super hungry. I want a snack. I didn't bring any because I was like, oh, you know, I can last till lunchtime. It's only, you know, the morning. Also, I didn't bring any coffee cups in with me because I was like, oh, it's not going to be that long. Next time I'm in is like next month. Like, what's the effing point? Also, I need to wee But the toilet is so far away. Like, for a year, I've been working basically right next to my toilet, it's just down the hallway. But now I'm gonna have to go all the way out the door, lock the door, go all the way upstairs, go all the way past the, like, common room or whatever, go to the bathroom. It's just, like, everything about post-pandemic life is a ball ache. It was, like, the same ball aches that were there before. But because I didn't know a life of working from home, I had no idea. I was like, that's just life. We just live our lives in this way. I had no idea that I was wasting so much of my life walking to the toilet. Does anyone else feel like that?
No, I think I'm ready to look in the fridge.
Oh.
Oh, there's a smell. Oh, okay.
It's been sorted out, apparently, by somebody else. But I bet it was an issue for them when they got in because there was a definite smell coming from there. I think we're gonna go over here away from there just now. I'm gonna stock up on stationery for home. Is that a dick move? I'll take rid of that. Ooh, a private and confidential stamper. I made a mistake. Oh no. Oh no. Can I fix it? Oh, I need to get out of here. Okay, so the person in this book that died, the official sort of magic police like theory as to what happened with her. They think that she tried this like theoretical magic spell and it like backfired and just sliced her in half. And originally when I read that, I was like, oh, okay, you know, what was gonna make her try some like really dangerous spell? You know, like what could it be that made her feel like, even with the potential consequences, she still needs to do this spell? And now I understand. She was bored at work. They found her in the library. That is the best place to be bored as shit and just trapped. Do you know what I mean? Like, if I could do magic now, I probably would try that spell. Like, if I was sliced in half, would it be better or worse than sitting in the office alone, waiting for the time to end so I can get a snack? Okay, it's time to go home. I'm on my way home. It is now soaking it down with rain. So that's another thing that I hate leaving my house for. Why would you come to the office in the rain when you can work at home? I don't know. Anyway, I apologize if this video was ridiculously boring and stupid, but it has actually passed the time a bit well, so I appreciate that. Thank you for watching. I will see you for the next, hopefully, non-boring video.